Hello, welcome. Recently, Yuzu for Android has seen improvements in over 70 games, including titles based on the Unreal Engine. In this video, we'll explore this update, but it's essential to note that information available on the internet isn't always entirely accurate, especially when it comes to emulation. Previously, there was a method to enhance compatibility and performance in Yuzu, especially for games based on the Unreal Engine, but that method required root access. Now, with this update, the question arises, is it the solution for those who want to avoid rooting their devices? If you enjoy first-hand news like this, don't forget to hit the like button so that this video can reach more viewers. And if this is your first visit, consider subscribing to the channel to stay updated with the latest news.
This video is offered by the members and Patreons of the channel. Thank you for your support.
When I came across this news, announcing that over 50 games that previously didn't work started functioning from version 168, I was extremely excited. Immediately, I began downloading several of these listed games to test and create a new list of compatible games, focusing especially on major titles. Among the choices were Batman Arkham Knight, which I consider one of the best games of my life, two games from the Kirby series, Metroid Prime Remastered, and even Crisis Core Final Fantasy VII. However, my excitement dwindled when I downloaded the games and started testing. I can state that, of the over 50 games experimented with, only about 10 worked correctly. I'll leave a list in the pinned comment with all the games that theoretically should work in the new updates, so that you can also test them. However, in my opinion, some games that didn't launch before and now do are considered playable on this list, without considering significant issues, like the case of Diablo II Resurrected, which has gameplay with FPS below 20, or Hellblade Senua's Sacrifice, which displays distorted colors during gameplay. Overall, it's amazing to see bright memory running on an Android device. But on the other hand, I still couldn't get Dragon Ball Z Kakarot to work, even though there is a way to make it work. I'll share brief snippets of some games that worked correctly. Starting with Bright Memory, as mentioned earlier, it's incredible to see such a detailed game running on a mobile device. All elements are present, reflections are rendered correctly, and the rain and gameplay can maintain a considerable frame rate most of the time. Crisis Core Final Fantasy VII Reunion also surprised, with good visual quality and solid performance, even facing enemies considered large, like Behemoth. However, it's noticeable that the GPU is being utilized at 100%, indicating the possibility of future improvements. Although the next three games are not on the list, it's important to mention that Dragon Ball FighterZ has not received improvements, and may experience issues in most battles if not using a rooted device. Alien Isolation, another game without specific improvements, is rendering as expected, with some lighting problems, but overall, it performs well. And the biggest surprise is that Red Dead Redemption no longer crashes on my device. The performance is still not ideal, even in handheld mode, but once the game receives performance improvements, it can be played in the palm of your hands. Diablo II Resurrected, as mentioned earlier, is now possible to enter the game, but the performance is quite poor, even in areas without enemies. The list also mentions Hot Wheels Unleashed, without specifying if it's the first or second game. In my tests with the first game, there is still unsatisfactory performance and several visual problems. Kirby and the Forgotten Land are playable for the first time. The overall performance is very good, providing a fun experience, whether playing alone or with a second player. Kirby Return to Dreamland had been tested before, presenting some mild visual issues at specific points. However, now the game is rendering correctly and with excellent performance. LEGO Star Wars: The Skywalker Saga is going in-game but faces shader issues. On my device, I had difficulty trying to run it for some time, resulting in random crashes after a short period. Life is Strange True Colors, despite having slightly altered colors, also has very good performance, and can be a good choice for those who just want to enjoy a good story during the year-end travels, as the game will work very well even with just touchscreen. Little Nightmares 2 is one of the games developed in Unreal Engine. It is already in-game, but presents many visual problems and constant GPU bottlenecks, requiring some optimizations to be playable. Metroid Prime Remastered looks visually very beautiful, with few performance-related problems and new areas loading almost instantly. For those who followed the release of this game, they know it had many issues loading new areas, and these problems do not occur on Android. However, both in my tests and in other reports, the game simply crashes after some gameplay time. Paper Mario the Origami King was one of the main games fixed by this update. However, on my device, I can't get past the introduction, no matter the configuration I use. Finally, Spyro Reignited Trilogy. Despite being able to go in-game, the game has performance issues and various visual defects, making it unplayable. Of the games I tested and didn't work at all were Batman Arkham Knight, where the game doesn't go beyond the main menu. Bravely Default 2 now goes past the menu, but like Paper Mario, it's not possible to enter the game. Mario Rabbit Sparks of Hope goes past the initial menu, but during the game, the screen turns all white. Dragon Ball Z Kakarot gets to the menus, but I can't go in-game. Jump Force freezes on the initial loading. If you disable NC, it's possible to reach the first area, but the performance is very poor. Vampyr also got to the menu, but I couldn't get in-game. Hellblade Senua's Sacrifice, despite getting into the game with decent performance, there is a problem with how colors are displayed, similar to what is seen in Life is Strange, only much worse. Bayonetta 3, performance has improved since the last time I tested, but it's still unplayable as most objects are not rendered correctly. Remnant from the Ashes, I was able to create the character, but the game freezes on the initial loading. I recommend that, if you really want to play any of the games on the list, test them on your device, but most are still not 100%. And that was the video. I hope it was useful for you, and until next time.